Hi there, this is Fakir Yogi Virendra Yogi. I was born in India, and in India there have been a lot of great sages, saints, philosophers, thinkers. You can see Rabindranath Tagore, Subhas Chandra Bose, and right here on my table you can see Lord Buddha. These all great people were original thinkers. They were self-reliant. They were dedicated, committed to really discover and invent something to really help the mankind. If I look into the areas of innovations, discoveries, C.V. Raman, S.N. Bose, J.C. Bose, and millions of great Indian scientists, the space scientists like Abdul Kalam and so many great people have made India a proud nation in the world, and India is developing and galloping very fastly and speedily. In politics also, you have seen the great leaders like Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, Narendra Modi, and so many great dedicated, committed politicians are there. This is the brighter side of the face of India. But you see, in the other side of the face of the coin, you will see the corruption. The Nehru dynasty has spoiled the country. Generation to generation, the corrupt people, they have looted the country. They made country vanquished. So corruption in politics. Corruption industry, you see, the industry people are just duplicating the foreign products and not giving the best service. Corruption is there. The Indian poor people, they trust their Indian products, but they are all not of the high quality. Our beloved Narendra Modi always says, self-reliant India. Self-run India can be only when the industrialists really make product which is equivalent to the standards of the Japanese cars and so many other products. But you will find corruption is there. They want just money. The greed has really spoiled, the selfishness has really ruined, and India is still clouded and eclipsed by corrupt people in every area. What I am driving at today in this, my small brief talk, even in IITs, in All India Institute of Medical Sciences, Indian Institutes of Technology, our engineering college, our medical college, everywhere there are a lot of research going. You will find a lot of people are doing MS, MD, MCH. A lot of people are doing, you know, PhD and all in IITs and all. But do you think they do genuine things? No. They are corrupt. I know so many people, bloody, because I am also a product of an IIT. They just steal theories from somebody else. And they manipulate. And the guides, they are incompetent, they have some degrees, but they don't have the virtues of a great scientist. So I appeal to the fraternity of Indian enlightened community, particularly the directors and all who are really in the helm, don't do corruption. In any area, India cannot become great. The dreams of our Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel or our Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose or Rabindranath Tagore, where he said, where the mind is without fear and head is held high, where knowledge is free. These things cannot be possible unless we are very honest and sincere, like this fakir. This fakir is original and honest, I tell you very honestly. I am original. I am Buddha. Look at. What is Buddha? Truth. You take more time but do genuine research. Do little but do quality product. Why you bloody make thesis after thesis? I know one man named Pradhan who was working under RNP in IIT Kharagpur. Every week he was publishing paper. He will go to the library, steal various topics, but he was intelligent. To be very corrupt and to be very crooked and to be very cunning, you need to be a very corrupt person. Publishing a lot of papers, and the corrupt RNP, he used to scold a lot of his students that, look, this great, glamorous, corrupt Pradhan is publishing paper weekly wise. And other guys are not doing. Shame. Hell with you idiots. Just for promotion and getting job, you want to acquire a lot of degrees, a lot of publications of papers. Because the people who are reviewing the papers, they cannot find fault because it is just stolen from some great discovery and research of the great scientists. Shame. Corruption in every field in India. Not only in India, abroad, everywhere else. Shame. By corruption, we cannot make the world a better place. The world has to be free and beautiful. There has to be adventure. There has to be growth. There has to be better satellites to go to different planets. There has to be greater means of communication. There has to be more discovery and invention. These all inventions cries for the goodness of man, the universal brotherhood and unity of us all. But what is happening? Greed has poisoned man's soul. It has barricaded the world in hate. It has gouged steps in misery, bloodshed, sorrow, suffering, corruption. These kind of scientists and inventors, the politicians, anybody in different fields, they can make India and world a great place. Never. Shame. Stop corruption. Be Buddha, be enlightened, know the truth. Little is better if it is quality that can serve the mankind better and develop your spiritual quality. Vasudeva Kutumbakam, the whole earth is our family. Atma Sarvutesu, every creature has to live on this planet earth, birds, fish and wild plants, with dignity, honor and pride because we are the savior. The birds, fish and wild plants cannot fight because they don't have the crooked brain of Xi Jinping, the Chinese dictator or Hitler. We are the savior, the saints, the sages, the philosopher, the thinker, the composer, the sculptor, the author, the writers. We are the savior of the earth, the dreamers. Dream a world where all are happy. Dream a world where all is progressing. Dream a world where science and progress is going to help every living creature on earth. That's my desire. That's my request. That's my cravings. And that's my sincere submission with humble and modesty to the world community. Arise, awaken, and stop not till such noble dreams are achieved collectively by all of us. Thank you.